So what we're talking about here is an entire economy that the DNA of it is based upon violence around the world. And it reaches up to the defense minister, the defense secretary, Ben Wallace. When he talks about the British occupation of Afghanistan and his sorrow about the people that will be left behind, let's not forget that Ben Wallace was the overseas director of Kinetic. Kinetic is an arms company that profited in the billion through the British presence in Afghanistan. What about the former Prime Minister, Theresa May? Well, her husband, Philip May, works for Capital Group. Capital Group, throughout the war on terror, have been the largest shareholder in Lockheed Martin and BAE Systems. Literally meaning that for every missile that is dropped by Lockheed Martin's or BAE Systems material, Theresa May's husband's company benefited. Let's not forget that throughout the war on terror, stocks in Lockheed Martin increased in value by 1,200%. This war displaced 37 million people across the planet. Guess who militarized the borders of the EU and the United States? Guess who benefited from that? Lockheed Martin, the very company that is partly owned by a company that Philip May works for. So the same companies that benefit from creating the refugees also benefit from preventing the peaceful passage of those refugees. What about Tony Blair? Well, Tony Blair is paid about £1 million a year as an advisor for the Mubadala Development Fund. The Mubadala Development Fund, based in the UAE, have for across the last 10 years been talking about their intention to extract $1 trillion worth of minerals from Afghanistan. So what we are talking about is a political elite which is literally knee deep in money from these kind of companies.